Have you ever adopted a puppy? Of course, you are all excited about your new friends, but the breeder will now also give you a pedigree records. That, of course, is not the animal, but it will help you take care of your animal and know which are his characteristics. This is very similar to Model Registry. Let me explain. As more and more organizations are infusing AI into their application, they are looking to establish a well-structured AI governance so that they can track the models that are currently deployed for inference into production and establish their provenance, and as well bake in safety practices of AI into their MLOps workflow. This is where Model Registry comes into play. Model Registry acts as a single pane of glass that helps you track the models from the initial inception, the inner loops of the MLOps workflow, throughout the entire model life cycles, to deployment for inference into production, the outer loop of the MLOps workflow. And today I'm going to show you a demo on how all of this works. Here I'm starting from the OpenShift AI dashboard. I navigate to the Model Registry page. Here I may have access to more than one Model Registry, but I can also select one to be my favorite. Here is the Model Registry that we will be using during this demo. As we can see, the Model Registry is currently empty, but I can start by registering a model that I previously prepared on the side. So here we can call the model fraud detection. We can start to fill in the version details. First attempt. We can enter the model format and the number, and I can use guidance from the existing Open Data Hub ODH connection to pre-fill some of the data and enter where the model is currently stored. By registering a model, we can see that we have the first version just created. I can go inside and add some more detailed information about this model, like for example, I want to add a label that this is for demo purpose, and maybe I want to annotate that this is a neural network. I also add some property like purpose demo to add additional information as a property. From here, we see that the model location has been correctly registered, and as well, I may deploy this model. But I will not do that one immediately because we are going to progress on this flow. From here, I can navigate to the data science project, and now I'm going to use one workbench to actually register a second version of my model. Here we can see that previously, I've also started to go ahead and do a second iteration of my models, and I've done some analysis and some little demo on the model locally. What I can do now is that I can register the model in this new version in Model Registry. I've just connected to the Model Registry, and now I can register this second version in my Model Registry. So now if I go and get the detail information, I can see all the new information that I've entered for the second version of my model. So this, we have just done it from the Model Registry Python client, but if I go back to the Model Registry that I was using just before and navigate to fraud detection, I can see that I have a second version of the model that contains all the new details that I wanted. So we can now deploy the second version of my model. I can select my project. I will select the saving runtime. I'm guided in selecting the model framework. I can also see that the Model Registry is helping me to identify what will be the recommended ODH connection and what is the path. So now I can go and click deploy. As you can see, the model has been deployed, and I invite you to check out the serving documentation of OpenShift AI in order to interact with this deployed model. Using also the same flow, but this time we can try to deploy it in another data science project,
I will select the usual steps, so I'm guiding selecting the model framework, but as we will see, we don't have the necessary credential in the new namespace. So what Model Registry does is that can help us to populate the non-confidential information that I need, but then it will be up to the Model Registry user to create the new connection by entering the username and the password that will be made available in the new namespace. Then the deployment flow will follow as usual. One additional thing that we can do is that we can undeploy this model version, and we can govern how the model has been undeployed in this case. And finally, I can as well go and archive this version. For example, this version is no longer needed because it's the one that I've used at the very beginning. And when my colleague will take over my work, I want them to use this version that is the latest one. I can also make use of standard labels or properties to mark the one that I prefer to have for A/B testing or comparative deployment.
So we have seen for traditional predictive AI how Model Registry helps us to track the different provenance of the machine learning models. Let's move now to generative AI, which is all the hype nowadays. And let's see in GenAI Ops or LLM Ops how Model Registry can help in this regard with another demo.
Moving on to generative AI use cases, we can start from the model catalog. The model catalog is a way to surface which are the models that are vetted and approved for use in your organization, in your company. Here we can see that we feature the Granite family of models, and we can see at a glance which one are available, what are the intended use cases. We can start by picking one, and we can delve into more details. We can see that we have a synthetic description, the model card rendering, that contains very many specific and detailed information on how this model is intended to be used, for as well the version, the labels that gives an indication of the task that this model is best suited for, the license agreement, provider, and current location. This is because foundation models are typically used for fine-tuning or alignment tuning, so that we can start this process actually by registering a model. Here we can select a use case. For example, I want to use this model to start the alignment tuning for my Granite chatbot. So starting with, I will use for my chatbot application. And then we can populate the rest and we will get it registered in Model Registry. So this is the base version that I will start it from. And here I have a button that you can start this lab tuning, for which I invite you to check out a separate video to delve into more details. As you will run this process, you will get your customized lab tuned version of the model. Here in this case, I've run it on the side, the lab tuned version, and therefore I have a new version that has been generated and created from running this lab pipeline in my data science project. And I can start to use this second version of the model using the deployment as we've seen in the previous section of this video, and use my customized model to integrate it in my AI infused application.
What we are looking next is to extend the integration of Model Registry, for example, with OCI infrastructure. In a cloud-native ecosystem, this allows us not only to have an efficient way to package and distribute machine learning models, but as well to integrate well-established standards of signature and attestations. We are also looking forward to integrate Model Registry with additional capabilities such as LLM eval, you will find a video in the description down below, and as well training operators. You can also find us in the upstream community, so don't forget to engage and let us know your feedback. I will see you in the upstream communities. Bye.